Hello, this is video lecture on VLSI testing and testability, and today's topic is third part of the BIST, built-in self-test. So in the previous tutorial we have seen an example for case 2, that is P equal to W plus 1. For that case, how to generate test vector we have seen. After that we have considered different methods of generating the test vectors. So if I look back there, you can see here, first one is nothing but syndrome driver counter, second one is constant weight counter, third one is LFSR shift register and LFSR XOR. So in that we discussed first two topics, that is syndrome driver counter and constant weight counter. So what is that syndrome driver? You are reducing or the signal or inputs share common source of signal. So that means here four inputs are there, but we can share AB and CD can share a same signal, common signal. So we can reduce number of test vector from 2 power 4 to 2 power 2. Another one is the constant weight counter, where we use x out of y code, where x is the maximum number of input variable on which output is dependent on. So value of y is chosen such that all 2 power x combination are available from any m column. So that is 2 out of 4 code. Any output if you take, it is a maximum function of 2 input. Now you see this 2 out of 4 code, you take any two column, there you will find all possible combination of two variables. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So we can exhaustively test all the output. Now in this video lecture, we are going to study two more techniques, that is LFSR, linear feedback shift register, in that with shift register, and LFSR with XOR. And these two are, I think initially we started with how we can generate, what are the different types of or different methods of generating test vector. So in that we discussed there were four methods. One is exhaustive, second one is pseudo exhaustive, third one is pseudo random pattern generator, fourth one is deterministic test. So what we did after studying exhaustive and pseudo exhaustive, we took the different hardware or circuits required to generate the test vector. That is four, in that four topics we discussed, that is syndrome driver and constant weight and these two, LFSR SR and LFSR XOR. So once we finish all the types of the circuits hardware required to generate the test vector, we will go for the other two methods, that is pseudo random pattern generator and deterministic testing. So what is LFSR? LFSR is nothing but a linear feedback shift register. So here the outputs of selected number of stages are fed back to the input of LFSR through an XOR gate. So it is basically a shift register. You will use n number of flip-flops and you will use XOR gate also, and there will be a feedback. So you are not going to give any input. The input is, it is generated within the system. So an n-bit LFSR can be represented by a irreducible primitive polynomial. What is that? We will see in the next slide. If the polynomial is of degree n, then LFSR will generate all possible 2 power n minus 1 non-zero binary pattern sequence. This sequence is termed as maximal length sequence of the LFSR. So what does it mean? If the polynomial is n, it can produce 2 power n minus 1. For example, polynomial n equal to 4. Then it will produce 15, that means 0, 0, 0, 0 will not be there. Apart from that, all other test vector it is able to generate. General representation is this one, polynomial of x is nothing but x power n plus p n minus 1 x power n minus 1 and p 2 x 2 like this till p naught. I will give an example, then you will understand what is this polynomial. Consider an example of polynomial degree 4. So polynomial degree 4, So if you take the polynomial as x to the power 4 plus x plus 1, so if you apply that or substitute in the previous formula in this, so what we get here, coefficient of x to the power of 4, that is coefficient of x to the power of 1, here it is 1, plus x to the power of 3 is not there here, x to the power of 2 is also not there, directly we have x to the power of 1, for that we have coefficient 1, plus 1 into x to the power of 0. Now if you want to write circuit diagram for this, first we have to decide how many flip-flops. Since polynomial is 4, we have to draw 4 flip-flops. Now what are the flip-flop or which flip-flop output we have to connect to a XOR gate? So we can name like this. So this is the first one, or x power 0, and this is x power 1, x power 2, x power 3 and x power 4. So what are the input for XOR gate? Plus 1 will be there always, but you have to see only the other two. So since x 4 plus x, that means I have to connect first flip-flop output and fourth flip-flop output. Suppose if it were x cube plus x square plus 1, then what you have to do, structure 4 flip-flop, there will be 4 flip-flops, but x square plus x cube plus 1, so third and second flip-flop output should be connected to XOR. So in that case, third one, that is this one and this one, this output should be connected to XOR, and we should not use these two. But here given polynomial is x to the power of 4 plus x plus 1. So this is what we get. Now assuming an initial condition 1 1 1, we can generate what are the possible test vector it can generate after applying each clock. So after applying the first clock, see, you can see after applying the first clock, what are the input for the this one first flip-flop? This Q and this Q, that is 1 XOR 1, that will be 0, that is ready to be fed to the first flip-flop when you apply the clock pulse. So that 0 is applied here, and other is simply shift register, so 1 1 1, it is shifted. Similarly, the next clock pulse, how to decide the first input, first signal, that is nothing but the XOR of first and fourth, that is first one is 0, fourth one is 0 XOR 1, that is nothing but 1. So first flip-flop will receive the signal 1, and then is simply shifting. So after this one, we can see that the sequence repeats. So you can see that all possible combination except 0 0 0 0 is generated here. So we can generate 4 bit test vectors, okay, 4 bit test vector using this LFSR, okay. So we have the third method, first method syndrome driver, second one is constant weight, third method is LFSR SR. So LFSR SR means it is LFSR with shift register. So this part constitutes LFSR, and you have two more test vector, so two more flip-flops that constitute nothing but shift register. So totally the below LFSR SR can be used to test any 5 input circuit in which no output is a function of more than 2 inputs. So this can be, it will generate that number of test number of bits will be 5, because 5 flip-flops you are using. Now no output is a function of 2 inputs, that means if you take any 2 column, you take AB, you will see all the 4 combination of 2 bit 1 1 0 1 0 0 1 0, or you take A and D, you take 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0, so all possible combination of 2 bits can be generated. So this LFSR with shift register can be used to test a circuit in which there are 5 inputs and none of the output is a function of more than 2 inputs. So we have seen such kind of example before. So there, how the test vector can be generated, this circuit can be used. So what it is, LFSR plus shift register. Now, fourth method is LFSR XOR. Here what we do is a little bit modification to the previous one. Instead of two flip-flops, we will use two XOR gate here. So previous circuit can be modified such that D is a linear combination of A and C and E is a linear combination of B and D. So instead of using a two flip-flops, we can use two additional XOR gate to generate 5 bits, that is A, B, C, D, E. Here also, if you assume initial value 00111, then you can generate this test pattern. So this is similar to previous, only difference is XOR gate. Instead of shift register, you have XOR gate here. Okay. So these are the four methods are used to generate the test vector. It is a hardware which generates, discuss about the hardware which generates the test vector. This example, try to work it out. What is the question? Find the test vector generated by following LFSR, assuming initial count it is, or initial seed means initial values for the LFSR to be 110. That is, this is LFSR. You can see 1, 2, 3. This is LFSR. So 110 and shift register, that is these three shift register. It is actually called convolved LFSR. You have XOR also and shift register also. It is a mixture of both. Okay. So we have seen in the previous LFSR only and shift register. Second one LFSR and only XOR. Here we have LFSR with shift register XOR, both you have. So it's a convolved one. So what is the question now? We have to find all the possible test vector generated by this LFSR. Initially you assume 110 for these three and 011 for these three. Next, you looking at that test vector, you suggest me that this circuit can be used to test a circuit pseudo exhaustively test, so I'll suggest an example circuit which can be pseudo exhaustively tested using the above test vector. So you tell me, give an example for the circuit, number of inputs and number of outputs, in that each output is not more than a function of not more than how many inputs, that you suggest me. Okay, this is a homework example, you try to solve it. Now after discussing test vector generator hardware, now we'll go back to the methods. So in that, first method was pseudo exhaustive, second method was pseudo exhaustive, and third method is pseudo random. So pseudo random pattern are sufficiently random in nature to replace truly random sequence. So pseudo random means it is not exactly random. There is a pattern if you observe, but it is enough to tell or enough to test a circuit randomly. Okay, so LFSRs are widely used. So we can see that previous circuit can be used for generating pseudo random test pattern. So there you can see, though the sequence what you get there random, but there is a pattern after finishing 2 power n minus 1, the sequence repeats actually. So it is widely used for generating test pattern. However, three aspects we have to consider to measure the effectiveness of pseudo random. First one is how many test vector you are going to generate. That is the first aspect you have to concentrate. Second one, by using those test vector, how many faults you can cover. So that is evaluation of the fault coverage. And third one is random pattern resistant fault, can it detect? So these three aspects we have to consider while if you want to adopt this testing generation method. We'll give a discuss the last one, that is what is that random pattern resistant faults. So suppose you take this AND gate with the 10 inputs. Suppose if E is stuck at 1, so then which test vector will identify the fault? 1 1 1 1 0 1 1. So this is the particular test vector can detect this fault. Now what is the probability of a LFSR generating this? So it is nothing but the 2 power minus n minus 10 probability. How we calculate it? Total number of bits is 10. So what is the probability of this coming out of 2 power 10? It is 1 by 2 power 10, that is 2 power minus 10. Now this is a huge, so in order to guarantee this one, we have to generate a huge number of test vectors. Otherwise probability of generating this will be very small. Again, why this is happening? We are assigning equal weightage for all the bits. That means probability of A becoming 1 or 0 is 0.5. So that's why 2 power minus 10 B. So if you take any example where we can see, we can identify a particular input where there is a chance of a particular fault, then we can adjust weight of that particular input. That means each bit will not be having 0.5 weightage, a particular bit will have more weightage of attaining a particular value. Okay, so we'll not discuss that one. Totally you have to consider this pseudo random pattern generator. So this type of fault, how we can detect. And the last one is the deterministic testing. So here, what is deterministic testing? We will use ROM. We will store all, we will decide what are the test vector to be used, and we will store in advance in the ROM, and we will apply. But it is rarely used because of high overhead associated with storing test pattern and their responses. So it is memory consuming and overhead associated with storing test pattern and their responses. So these are the four test vector generation methods, and we have also seen four test generator circuit hardware also. Okay, so that is for today's tutorial.